all the coin seems to be there, if a little blood-stained. You lot are enthusiastic about your lord's work.
Our lady. We serve only the Absolute.
Oh, silly me. We Zentarim are so long past our own godly roots, I'm afraid I forget the half of them. But you, I know. When did you start worshipping gods? Did they give your wee rodent a worm friend, too?
Rodent?
Enough! You will show the Stone Lord proper respect, and you will return to the Guild Hall and do as we have paid you to.
Of course. I only thought...
Wait. Flop all you wish, little fish. But Minsk has caught you!
On that note, good luck. The job will be done by the time you get to the Guild Hall.
This is my happy place.
You lot on my mind and, well, in it.
How delicious. A crooked touch.
there.
Don't touch me.
What's there?
They're bright, gaudy, and almost never make good poisons. Each their own, I suppose.
Although I am right.
If we'd only pushed through.
I know, love. But think about it too.
Sleep for a 10 days.
Didn't wait to show off the scars to a friend's skin. Watch this.
Smells like fermented baby fart. The hint of...
You could really detect the ball fight in the aftertaste.
Observe the delightful color. Dilla was pissed and twice as rank. Exquisite.
Either watch or leave.
Witness the fever. Putrid form of our deceiver. Witness. He adopts his.
It's not a lie. If you would just listen, I could explain.
You have done quite enough explaining, Volothamp Gadan. You have poisoned the very hearts and minds of these good, kind, gentle citizens with your lies, your delusions, your conspiracies. Though you hide behind a mask of stories, we have seen beyond the veil. We see what you really are, fearmonger.
Hear, hear!
Attention seeker!
Hear, hear!
Agent of chaos!
Your parasite stirs in recognition. This man is infected.
Wreck the hells follow!
Today, citizens, we rid ourselves of this cankerous sore. Today, we burn away all falsehoods. Today, we will be divided no longer, for today, we rise in truth!
Psst! Don't you stand there! Help me, goddammit! Help me!
This damsel may be middle-aged, but let's get him out of distress, hmm?
The new- newcomer speaks, and speaks of evidence, and trials, and justice. And in so doing, they delay their very own salvation. Dear citizen, dear friend, rest assured you will have your justice. But I'm afraid the time for trials has passed. Now is the time for judgment!
No! Please! No!
dull moment.
Gods! I really thought I was done for. I suppose thanks are in order. Again, what's an heroic story without a little risking of one's neck, eh?
And you know what they say, the bigger the story,
the more people want to kill you for it. You of all people will, know what I mean. I'll, tell you what I know, but not here. Too many eyes, ears, weapons about. Meet me at your camp,
Soldier.
Of course they do. They're fish.
This catch is spoiled. You'll have to wait for the next boat.
I hate sending Leepak and the girls off without me.
But if that smuggler can get them to Waterdeep and away from the Absolute...
This is life and death for me too, mate. You only get as many berths on my sloop as you can pay for. If I allow any freeloaders, my own crew will scrag me. Very well, I'll do it. Suppose I can find some way to make it good with the crew.
Hells, it's everywhere still. I don't suppose you've got any experience getting oil out of sealed wood. I don't really have any to spare.
Maybe if I tried pissing on it.
Now, did you want something, or do you just have an interest in fishing vessels? Me and Flea here were out on the water casting our nets, expecting to find the usual crop of halibut. Then, all of a sudden, my net starts dragging, and there's a bloody wave serving all twisted up in it. We took her back to the docks to try and help her, but she was already dead. And the other wave servants came to get it. Her. Sorry. They took her back to the temple. You can hear the bloody caterwauling from here. We both saw some sort of wake moving towards the docks when we picked her up. But there weren't any other boats around. Maybe it was something big moving underwater. I don't know. It was weird, whatever it was. Kind of looked like it might have been heading towards that building across the channel, actually. Buggered if I know. Might be something to do with all that oil in the water. It's too bad we can't sell them. Bloody waste, if you ask me. The port's fine, but the nets are in tatters. Need to deal with all this oil before we can fix them, though.
Can't talk. Bloody oil's gummed up me.
Including fees.
War is good for some businesses. What can I say? I got mouths to feed too.
I don't know who you are, but all I can say is thank you. If you ever have children, you'll understand what you've done for us.
Oh, Wave Mother, Queen of the Depths, hear me. Please carry Holly to her final rest in the deep wilds. Please. Sorry, are you here for Wave Servant Holly's funeral? Oh, it's already started. They're just inside. All are welcome to come and celebrate the life of the fallen wave servant. May the Wave Mother smile on you as she did Holly.
She knows you've given her all. Let's start to store right now.
There's no
have offerings in here for a trip to the vault. Off you go.
I was just about to... Sorry, mate. No time to chat.
The celebration is in the main chamber. Praise Umberly!
Rejoice, sisters, for Umberly has blessed her humble daughter with a pure death. Her lips blue with her kiss, her lungs full of her quenching word. Umberly's mercy saved her from a slow, sinking death in the beast's shadow. How dare this beast sully the safety of Grey Harbor? We will find its master and send him struggling into the Bitch Queen's embrace. Not a sweet sleep like Holly's, but a suffocating flood of fruitless garths and bursting flesh. You, supplicant, what tribute do you bring to honor the Wave Mother's fallen daughter? Then you know as well as Umberly that blood must soon be shed. Your tribute is well received. Breathe deep as she permits. Yes. Thank the Wave Mother. Blessed Umberly saw fit to spare her an ignoble death. But her passing was not as the Wave Mother intended. It was a beast who took her life. An unnatural one whose very existence is an affront to Umberly. A wretched metal monstrosity hewn by hubris. A rusting pollutant that bleeds black blood into Umberly's pristine waters. The Queen of the Depths is generous to those who serve her, and her favor is far less deadly than her wrath. Find the master of this poisonous beast and slay him. Then one of her most precious gifts shall be yours. That privilege is not yours to earn. The beast struck Holly while she was swimming in Grey Harbor. She was found by some fishermen. We haven't found its lair as yet. Perhaps you can find where the beast takes its slumber and skewer it before it wakes. Salt kiss your brow. We await your return and the beast master's demise. Rejoice. As the Wave Mother welcomes another daughter to the deep wilds, we too shall gladly follow when our time has come.
Fish's piss. I loved Holly as much as anyone, but they've been wailing and praying for hours. My best pot for a bit of quiet.
There's nothing for you up here, Flotsam. Back downstairs you go.
Most holy death. Glorious Wave Mother. Pour fury upon the beast responsible.
something over there.
Leave its master. A bloated carcass in the spume.
If they're right about the Swahagan, I may take up another line of work. Though nothing seems safe these days.
You hear these mooks trying to tell me about fishing? I've been fishing here all my life.
The others think I don't know shit, but I do. I do know shit.
Did you hear the wave servants talking about a beast in...
Wash them all. Marek will never let you sell them like that.
Watch this. Smells like fermented baby fun. With a hint of
nothing.
If we'd only made the effort.
I swear, this fist is just trying to provoke me, but I'm not gonna fall for it.
Greetings, citizen.
Common folk need to learn to respect authority. Good thing I'm happy to teach them.
These goods need to be delivered
peacefully,
isn't it?
What a scene. Whoever did this had no rhyme or reason. Just viciousness.
long road ahead.
A young cave bear, killed and stuffed before its teeth were fully grown.
Who are you? Another who needs to learn the difference between right and wrong?
A Githyanki youth, and a familiar one at that.
I am Petaris, and I am good. Father was bad. They all were. I tried to make them better, but they were not strong enough. They lacked resolve. Havkalag, he brought me from the shell, raised me quickly, taught me to be good, but he failed me. He was not righteous. He was not innocent. His thoughts were impure. Such evil can only be cured one way. With pain. With torment. And if that does not work, with death. Tell me, are you a good person? There is only one way. The Petarian Code. Do you follow it? It is honor. Justice. The true form of goodness we all must live by. Decreed by Bahamut himself. You are not capable of following its teachings. I know what you did to me. I see the memory of it. Right there in your head. You stole me from my people. Gave me to that woman. Unhatched. Defenseless. You let me be brought here so Father could hurt me. You are bad. You must be taught a lesson.
He deserved it. They all deserved it. I should feel better now. Why don't I feel better?
My what? Father said I lacked a conscience. He said I was a nasty, evil thing, but he could make me good. He cured me.
But why would he hurt me if I didn't need to be cured?
The code is flawed, and I am a monster, as he said I was. I cannot be trusted. What have I done?
No one back home will ever believe this.
I'd love to, thanks.
Thank you.
to rest.
You're living in is this one. Worry about the next one when it comes.
Let's have a look.
All these people. They should be at home with their loved ones.
Look around you. It's peaceful, isn't it?
Yes, for the moment. For how long?
The only moment you're living in is this one. This is a complete waste of time. It's peaceful, isn't it?
Stand back! I can't have laymen disrupting the...
Pardon my singing. That lullaby has been stuck in my head since... Funny. I can't recall.
Wonderful little beast. Nimble as anything.
Nothing stands out about the man.
There was a squirrel in the tree. Marvelous creature. Inquisitive and nut-crazed. Oh, just tired, I suppose. It's been quite a long day. Or at least I think it has. You wouldn't happen to know where I live, would you? I am very pleased to meet your acquaintance. And you are?
This is more than a lapse, you sense. Something's been done to the man's memories.
Well, I remember I was sad. But in truth, I'm not quite sure what caused it. I'm not even sure I know what side it is anymore. And I came from that building over there. They were very nice to me. Seemed very helpful. Though, for the life of me, I can't recall what I was doing there in the first place. There must be, you would think. You know, I can swear there is someone, but their name escapes me. Hells, even their face escapes me. A figment of my imagination, perhaps. Oh, it will come back to me. Or not. I'm content enough here, in either case.
Of the foundry. Belching smoke and metal screeches.
This city has been in a downward spiral for too long. Only the soft-hearted and the street...
Creeps in cloaks creeping around down in the sewers.
Stranger things have happened in Baldur's Gate.
The clanking great steel watchers.
They have made the right decision.
Bloody hate them. No matter what the mouth says.
Contraband! Something over there.
Find a mermaid's breath.
For striped sails, they said. Every other ship's got stripes on its sails. Like asking us to look for a fish with a tail.
I'm starting to think.
Would have helped if it at least told us which direction the stripes are supposed to be in.
Whoa, whoa, mate. This is the last place you need to be. Clear off, yeah? Two words. Guild business. Only an idiot gets between them and their shipments. Easy, mate. We're humble smugglers, all right? So just take whatever you want. Not enough that the guild will have my head for this. You want to leave my little ones copperless too? God damn it all. Fine. Here, take it and go.
I'd kill for a pint of mermaid's breath. These city brews ain't got much bite to them.
Leave before I decide killing you is worth the risk.
I'm starting to think they've forgotten about us.
Your behavior has caused upset. Now a fight is unavoidable.
Over here.
fight. Let's go.
To do it.
On this day.
Aren't those strikes?
Icy strikes.
Citizen, I'm going to call for a coffin cart.
I'm not sure, honestly. It's been a couple of hundred years.
Oh, you're missing out.
Loved it as a kid. This water looks nasty as hell, though.
Oil? Leading right inside.
travel, I might. Should be easy.
Sometimes the only way out is through. I wonder if this is worth the cost.
pipes and pumps. That must be how they keep this basement dry, though it's clearly below harbor level. According to the label, this urn is filled with G-cube lubricant. How many gelatinous cubes would have to be rendered down into slippery salve to fill an urn this size? According to the label, this urn is filled with G-cube lubricant. How many gelatinous cubes would have to be rendered down into slippery salve to fill an urn this size?
Keep your distance, darling.
No one stopped me yet.
What's this? You ain't supposed to be down here, mate.
You spot a curious metal contraption in the water. A submersible.
The Duke? I mean, if you see him, let him know I'm down for a drink. But he ain't here. Which begs the question, what are you bloody doing down here? Let me guess. This is about them Umberly servants. You tell them to stay out of the way. Cap needs the right of way. He can't stop on a dime when they go darting in front of the prow. Bloody salt is always flopping around in the water. I've almost hit one or two now. Might have even nicked one off the port bow the other day. Maybe that'll teach them to keep out of the way. This big boy, the captain of Grey Harbor, built him with my own two hands, can take the passage between here and the Iron Throne faster than you can say, fuck the Absolute. Nothing without Lord Gortash's go-ahead. I transport whoever he needs taken to the Iron Throne. Prisoners, mostly, but that's his business. Oh, yeah? And are you here to make good on that? And you're the judge, jury, and executioner, is that it? Yeah, right. Say goodbye, kid.
Easy these days.
Still on my feet.
Now, how for a skeleton key? Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times. Thank you.
Is it done? Have you slain the Beastmaster? Umberly smiles on us all. Thank you for enacting her blessed vengeance. May the tides crush his bones to sand. As promised, the Wave Mother rewards those who submit to her will. May the seas be as kind as you.
You don't have permission to be here. You're about to be ejected. You managed to talk your way in. No easy feat. It seems the rules have not changed in your absence. You're still trespassing.
yourself. Is ever easy. Survival is all that matters.
What's it gonna take? Never a dull moment.
Must have stayed interesting.
It is splendid to see you again, my friend. If you hadn't saved me from that mob, I'd be penning a guide to the afterlife based on first-hand experience. Perhaps you would hazard a guess as to why the mob turned on me? Posh. That strutting tyrant has a long reach and a steel fist, but he's a puppy dog compared to the real horror that haunts our streets. The Lord of Murder has returned. As he did 100 years ago, Baal has set his accursed sights on Baldur's Gate, and his temple runs red with the blood of the innocent. And just as then, he has more than one chosen to manifest his gruesome plot. He has Auron, and he has you. You triumphed over Baal's chosen? Marvelous! And what will you do with that power? Slaughter the city? Brutalize the world? This is not the first time your kind have threatened Baldur's Gate, and the city still stands. It will survive you,
And so will I. From as great a distance as possible.
My fondest congratulations for your work in the temple. Well done indeed. On this eve, Skeletus gazes upon perfection. You shall be a graven god, my demiurge. All you must do now is heed your father's advice when the time comes. Survive? I did not. It was my favorite death yet. As he does each time I expire by your side, Baal has sent you another loyal Skeletas to watch over and adore you. Not half as much as the world over will fear you. It won't be long, my lord. It won't be long.
Asking the impossible. Gyrenetics require a steady hand and a sharp gaze. I can barely keep my eyes open. I need to rest.
You have a son, do you not? Is he as lazy and pathetic as his spineless mother?
Wait! Stay your hand, I beg you.
Prinsky's motivation sequence activated.
Tell me, Gondian. Tell me about your son.
He's not... Yes, Overseer Holt. He's frail in body and mind like me, like all of us. Yet by your grace, he lives.
And your wife?
She is... was useless. And interfered with production quotas. You were wise to remove her from this world. Forgive my outburst. I will work through the night. This watcher will be operational by dawn.
I will allow it. But if your work is anything short of impeccable, your son will die screaming. Is that clear?
Yes. Overseer Holtz.
Red Brother, stand ready. Gondians, so much as twitch, and I'll rip your tongues out myself. An interloper? How did you get in here? It matters not. You revealed yourself for nothing. The Gondians wouldn't know a spine if I ripped it from their backs and beat them with it.
You're wrong. Even if we beg, even if we humiliate ourselves, it won't matter. You'll kill us all anyway.
What was that?
I said, we shall bow no more. For the glory of Gond!
It's hot in here.
Deactivated. Thank the gods.
Shall we cut and run?
deal with the bodies. Blessed be. What have we done? They're dead. They're all dead. No. You don't understand. The Overseers hold more than our lives hostage. They have our families. And if they see what we've done, killing me will only be the beginning. God help us. If I hide the corpses, the smell will attract someone. I need to dispose of them.
We need to get rid of these bodies. Right now.
I could cut them off. Or perhaps incinerate them.
I can't! I'm so dead!
What if I get caught?
No. I'm not thinking like that.
There's so much blood. Oh, the smell.
One problem at a time. Deal with the bodies.
God, help me.
We need to get rid of these bodies. Right now.
Blood!
If I hide the corpses, the smell will attract someone.
Bastards, sir.
We've got to be safe.
I need to dispose of them. I could cut them up.
So much blood.
Or perhaps incinerate them.
Smell!
What if I get caught?
Get rid of these bodies. Right now.
I'm not thinking like that.
Bastards deserve it.
I have to clean up the body. One problem at a time. Deal with the body.
So much blood. Oh, and the smell.
If I hide the corpses, the smell will attract someone. I need to dispose of them. Them up, or perhaps incinerate them. What if I get caught? No, we're not thinking like that. One problem at a time. Deal with the body.
I won't give in. No choice but to keep going. With haste.
chance of.
Here, in unpowered prototype form, stands a completed steel watcher, the proudest achievement of the Foundry, and a tribute to the untiring efforts of the Baneite overseers. Targeting module, an optical focus device, is fitted within the Watcher's helm to enable aiming of the harpoon bow.
Behind the corpses.
Spill some blood.